Hey guys, welcome back to another Copycat Friday, and we have something very special for you in store. In fact, we didn't really have a choice. We had to make it because you requested it so much. And guys, you were correct. The effect is super cool and must be made. Of course, I'm talking about the cool green screen rotation effect from Joyner Lucas' latest music video, Revenge Intro. Or is it called ADHD? I don't know. However, here you can see Joyner Lucas walking through different scenes all in one take. And even more crazy, he interacts with people and objects in the scene. Very insane if you ask me. But luckily, he also posted a behind the scenes video on his YouTube channel, so breaking down the effect became a lot easier. Thank you so much! Now, because this effect requires some preparations, let's not waste time and start with the effect. The first thing we are going to do are the backgrounds we are going to use. In the original video, they used a motion-controlled rig to always get the same movement for the background and for the foreground. However, we decided not to use this technique because we wanted to make it accessible for everyone. At first we thought to ourselves, let's use stock clips. However, we noticed real quick that this wasn't the right method. The stock clips needed to be scaled up a lot and became quite pixelated. That's why we went searching for another method, which we found in panoramic photos. It doesn't really matter how you make them, as long as they are wide enough and have a large resolution. You can make these in many different ways, like with your cell phone or with your camera. With the camera, you can make your photos while holding it in portrait mode. Afterwards, you can then combine them in Photoshop or in Lightroom.
They're talking about Lightroom. As you guys know, I'd recently started with photography, and so I had to post, color grade, and manage my photos in Lightroom. But to get started faster with that new program, I actually followed a class by Tabitha Park on Skillshare. Now, Skillshare is not only our sponsor, but also genuinely a platform that I love, because we also make classes for Skillshare, such as our Premiere Pro class, our After Effects class, which has been going really well, and we've been building a community on there. Now, going back to Tabitha Park and her Lightroom class, it's a short class, only 1 hour long, so I'm able to get started with Lightroom a whole lot faster, and that way I'm also sure that I'm not missing anything if I would start learning Lightroom myself. Now, apart from Tabitha's class and my classes, of course, there are tens of thousands of other classes on Skillshare, which you have all access to with an active Skillshare subscription. Now, because they're sponsoring this episode right here, you can click the first link in the description down below to get an exclusive 2 months for free access to Skillshare. And after that, it is super cheap, even less than $10 per month. So check it out right now, guys. Link in the description down below. And now, back to you, Janik.
Okay, we already have our backgrounds. Now let's continue with the rest of the effect.
I mean, we were just sitting back, you know, chopping it up, reminiscing about the good old days and all that. You know, tracking my roots, where I came from and where I'm going. But like I say, man, always said it, it's not about the destination.
Okay, we already have our backgrounds, now let's continue with the rest of the effect. Okay guys, the first thing you are going to need is a green screen, and you can use a portable one, but they are quite limited due to their size. So if you can, you can build a large one, just like we did. And we built ours on these rolling stands from Cupo, because we need to follow along with the gimbal movement and always keep our actor inside the green.
The new scene that we'll create has to be placed within a 3D space, and we can do that in After Effects with a 3D tracker. Now, in order to make that 3D tracker work well, we need structure on the floor. If you don't have structure, like we do on our concrete floor here in the studio, then just throw a bunch of stuff on the floor and you got structure. It's that easy.
In the original clip, you can see Joyner Lucas interacting with people and objects. Well, we're not gonna do that because our green screen isn't big enough for that. But what we are going to do is the changeable lights. We can easily do this with our studio lights right here. We can turn them off and on again. But the fun thing is that you can also do this at home with just normal lights.
And then of course comes the camera work. Now in the video clip they shot everything on a dolly, so you can take out your dolly system and, you know, shoot it like that. Or you can also take out your gimbal, which most people have at home. That way you get smooth shots. We're just going to walk around in circles around the subject, make sure that it stays in the green screen, and of course, you also want to make sure that you film the floor to get some structure, as we need that data for the 3D camera tracking. Now, if you don't have a gimbal, you can of course also go handheld, but then you will get lots of movement and shakiness, so a gimbal definitely looks better. And that's it! Back to you, Janik.
Okay, that was it for all the preparations and the footage. We can now start with the post-production, and this will be in After Effects. So take your green screenshot and drag that into the composition. So the first thing we are going to do is some camera tracking. So in the tracker panel, click on the camera tracker button and let After Effects do its thing. When After Effects is done with the tracking, we are going to look for some tracking points on the ground. When you have found some tracking points where the target is the same angle as the floor, you can right-click on that. Then choose Set Ground Plane and Origin, again right-click on the same tracking points, and now choose Create Null and Camera. Okay, the tracking is already done. Now it's time to key out the green. Search for the key light effect in the effects library and drag that to your clip. Okay, you know the drill. Take the color picker, select the green, fine-tune if necessary, and create a mask to remove the rest of the scene. It can be possible that you need to animate the mask, and this is because of the up and down movements of the camera. But once you have done this, you will have a medium shot of your actor completely keyed out. Oh yeah, you can also position and scale the actor in the spot that you want. Next, we are going to add the background to the composition and drag it underneath the actor clip. The first thing you now can do is make the background 3D by pressing this button. However, this will place the background near the tracking points we chose earlier. Not something we want. So scale the clip back up and rotate it in the right angle. Then position it correctly on one side, and this is quite important. Due to the movement of the camera, the background will also move. So it can be possible that you need to animate the position and the orientation of the background to avoid black edges when moving to the other side. Then the last step for the background is making it curved. Open up the properties for the background layer, then open up the geometry options and increase the curvature to around 30% and the segments to the maximum. If done correctly, you will already have a matching background. Now the last step is a transition from one scene to the other. Look for the point where the light changes, and here we are going to introduce a new background. In the original clip, you can see that they use multiple different transitions. Well, we are going to create one which you can use as a base for other transitions. The transition we will make is a fast wipe in with an extra touch. One object comes in first, and then the rest of the scene wipes in. So place the second background in your composition and above the first background. Then do the exact same steps for the background as before. Duplicate the background once, and now let's create some masks. Mask out the object you want to appear first on the original second background layer. Then on the duplicate of the second background, you can add the linear wipe effect. Animate the effect so that it reveals the background. Now the object that appears first only needs to be visible for a short time. So let it start just before the light changes and let it end on the moment that the duplicate is completely visible. And that's all for the transition. However, they also have one extra detail, an exposure adjustment. This you can easily do with the Lumetri effect. When an element from the transition comes in, animate the exposure for that element. Crank up the exposure in the beginning and animate it back to normal after a few frames. Do this for each element of the transition. So for us this means the first element popping in and the whole clip being revealed. Of course, don't forget to ease in and ease out. Or is it ease out and ease in because you place the out for it and then the inside? I don't know, just ease in and ease out. Met this cat named Larry, he was with the Avengers. Show me how to make moves and walk with the winners. Soon went to the pen and never seen him again. But I did a couple shows with his friends. Lumberjack, brown clown, so and so, and dude with the orange pants. 10 years later, now I'm rocking the orange pants. But they jabos though. Okay guys, let's do a super quick Janik Fun Fact Fountain! Apparently, Jordan Lucas' biggest inspiration is Eminem. And I think he saw 8 Mile a little bit too much. Apparently he has some beef with other rappers such as Logic and Hobson. I like beef. Anyways, maybe it has something to do with the fact that he really has ADHD. ADHD. It would explain the title of his new album. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you learned something new. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Skillshare for the support. And like always, stay creative. I'm a bird. Doing some capoeira. I'm Chewy.